Hey, Spawn Camp Games here. If you remember last time we set up this indicator arrow. It runs around our screen, looks for this here landing platform. On this one, I'll show you what I have set up. Just go ahead and play. And shakow, we have this this ugly white canvas here. What it does is it follows our arrow around also. And it's going to tell what our distance is to the landing platform. So the way I have that set up, let's see, we'll go over here in our screen boundary system. We have this arrow distance, and this is just referring to this this canvas, this little extra canvas that I made. We go in here and look, and we have a game object arrow distance, and then down here, it just waits for 3.5 seconds after the game starts, and then it sets the arrow to true. Pretty simple. We also have this follow arrow with offset, so if we go down here into our canvases and we have this distance canvas that I created, that's that really bright white thing that we're gonna work on today. We go down and we look and we have a follow arrow with offset, so we open this up, we go to the top here and we have a target transform, and that's just our indicator arrow. And then we have four vector twos that I use as offsets. We have a player transform that's just cached here and on awake or on enable, and it just finds the player tag, sets the transform. So on our update loop, at the very beginning, we have an offset to apply that we set to vector 2.0, and then we run through these checks, and all these do is just add our offset to the appropriate side of the screen. If we're on the left side, it'll add the left offset, and so on and so on. Then down here we have a total offset. We set that to the target.transform position. We add our offset onto that, and then we have a transform.position, and all we're doing is lerping from our current position to our total offset by, at the moment, just a hard-coded 10. And that's what we have set up so far. Today we're going to go through and we're going to make this a little bit prettier on the eyes and hopefully set up the distance check. And then the movement is a little wonky, but we'll get to that in another devlog. So the first thing we'll do is we'll go in here. We're going to activate this thing so we can see it. And the white, a little bright. So let's go ahead and fix that. So we go, let's open it up. We got background sprite or image. I'm going to change this to black. And then we're also going to set the opacity down to about 101. Let's try this.
3, 2, 1, 0.
Yeah, that looks a little better. And what we could do, could duplicate this. Say, we'll go in here and make it a little smaller. Like this, and then we can set this to a white. Let's see what this looks like.
3, 2, 1, 0.
I kind of like that, but let's go backwards. Let's go black on top, and we'll go white on the bottom, and then we'll set the black a little darker. Let's see what that looks like.
3, 2, 1.
Okay, I like that a little better. Looks pretty good. So, now that we have this, let's set up a text element on top of it. So we'll go to Text Mesh Pro. This thing is freaking enormous. Let's go over here and let's just, boom. Nope, that didn't work too well. So let's go. We'll just center it. I guess that's centered. So we'll go here, and we'll go center, and we'll go here, and we'll go center. That's better. Yep, that's a lot better. So we'll go down and let's drag this guy so I can see a little better. We're going to set this to auto size. We're gonna set the max to be, like, why not do 10 or 18? And the min can be 1. It's still a little too big. Let's turn him off. Let's just do 1. Enter. We'll zoom in. He's still way too big. So we're gonna go 0.5. Perfect. Oh, I said 0.5 and I put 0.4. So we're gonna open this guy up. We're gonna use the text that we've been using for this project. And now he's a little bit too big. So go 0.2, 0.3. 0.3 looks good. It's gonna be a number, so. And then we'll see. Let's see what this looks like.
3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Could be a little bigger. So we'll go 0.4. And can we put meters on the end? We can. Let's do this.
3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
I like it. I mean, he's there, but he's not there for, I mean, like, you're just going to glance at it. It's not going to be. Let's move our platform somewhere above us. It's going to be there, but you're not really going to care about the distance too much. You just want to know where the platform is. So, you see what I mean with the little bit of a wonky movement? Yeah, we'll get to that. Right now, let's just worry about our distance. So, let's go back into our, where is he here? We can rename this to distance text. And we already have a raycast from our player to our thing. Or to our landing platform. So let's find our player. And we'll go down, open up this. Here he is, raycast toward finish. So we'll open him up. Say if our distance is this. We could also set our distance. So let's go. So we have an arrow indicator. Let's go down here and we're gonna make a new public game object called, since this is sitting on the canvas and the arrow's sitting somewhere else, we can't really combine the two. So we're just gonna say our distance indicator. We're gonna save, we'll go back into Unity, let this compile. Now we have our distance indicator, and we'll go down and find our distance canvas. Drop him in there. Save. Go back here. Okay, so now we can just go distance indicator dot set active, and we're gonna do what you do. And then we're gonna say distance indicator dot set active, and then do what you do as well. Save. Let's see. Wait and enable arrow. Yeah, that works. So now we have our distance right here. So we can just go in here and say, well, let's go to using statements. Go to using text mesh pro. And then we're gonna set up a new text element, so public, and then text mesh. I like using this guy here. We're gonna call this our distance text. Hit save, go back. Now we have a text mesh element we can fill in. So let's go our distance text. Drop him right in there. Save. Now we can disable this guy because I don't think we need him much anymore. So we can go back into the script we were working on. And here, I think we have a debug for our text, or our distance, we do. So, we don't need him anymore because we're going to be seeing him on the actual text element. So, if arrow is active, that seems like a good spot to do it. No. Yeah. Because we're going to set him active. So we can still change the text and set him active. So if the arrow is active, then we're going to say our distance text dot text equals, and then we're going to say distance dot to string plus space M. File save. Let's get rid of the space. File save. Okay. Let's go back, hit play, let's see what we're working with.
3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have
Oh
liftoff.
Yeah. So we don't need don't need that many numbers. So let's go in here. So here I think we're gonna go dist equals math f dot round and then we're gonna say dist would look good with just an integer. See.
3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
I think that'll work. See, there's a little bug that we need to fix. But we'll fix that later. Alright, that's all we're going to do today. Thanks for watching.